The P key and the S key are used to change the parameters of the servo motors or to change other functions. Additionally, if your sewing machine is equipped with an LED light, you can turn the LED light on or off by pressing the S button. In standby mode, if your sewing machine is equipped with a needle position sensor, you can move the needle up or down by pressing the P key. By pressing the P key, you can move the needle up and down without turning the handwheel. While in standby mode, you can easily increase or decrease the speed by pressing the plus and minus buttons. If you want to change the direction your servo motor rotates to forward or backward, while in standby mode, press the P key and the plus key at the same time. Then you can see P00 on the display. If something other than P00 is displayed, for example, P17, use the plus and minus buttons to change P02. After selecting P02, next, press the P key. Then you can see 1 on the display. Change 1-2-0 by pressing the plus button. Then save by pressing the S key. This allows you to select 1 to rotate the motor backwards for the overlock machine and save. This allows you to select and save the motor to rotate forward 0 for normal machine. Generally, servo sewing machine motors operate at speeds between 1000 RPM and 7000 RPM. If operating at a maximum speed of 7000 RPM is a hindrance to you in completing your sewing tasks, you can always maintain your desired speed without exceeding it. For that, you need to use the speed lock feature, which is done like this. Press the P and minus buttons at the same time. Then you will see the first 0 on the display blinking 0000. Four zeros appear on the display, the first 0 blinking. Now you need to enter the passcode. You can enter any password you like. I'll use 2024 as an example. Using the plus key, the first 0 is changed to 2. Next, press the P key again. Using the plus key, then the next 0 will start blinking. That 0 is unchanged. Press the P button again. Using the plus key, the third 0 changes to the 2. Press the P button again. Using the plus key, the fourth 0 changes to 4. Press the S button to save. The display changes to P00. Using the plus key, change to P01. Pressing the P button, the maximum speed is shown as 7000 RPM. Using the minus button, change to the maximum speed you want. Let's say your desired maximum speed is 2000 RPM. S, who are you serving? Press the S button to save. Now, when I increase the speed by pressing the plus key normally, it does not go above 2000 RPM. If you want to remove speed lock, press the P and minus buttons at the same time. Then you will see the first 0 on the display blinking 0000. Four zeros appear on the display, the first 0 blinking. Now you need to enter the passcode. The passcode is 2024. Using the plus key, the first 0 is changed to 2. Next, press the P key again. Using the plus key, then the next 0 will start blinking. That 0 is unchanged. Press the P button again. Using the plus key, the third 0 changes to the 2. Press the P button again. Using the plus key, The fourth zero changes to 4. S. Who are you serving? Press the S button to save. Now the speed lock is removed, so you can increase the speed to 7000 RPM if desired. Using the speed lock feature can also prevent unwanted people from increasing or decreasing the speed of the motor. You need to watch the speed at which the motor is working by pressing S and P keys simultaneously. Then you can see the C01 display. Now press the P key. Press the pedal switch down. While the motor is running, you can see the speed of the motor rotation on the display, according to the current conditions. These C01 parameters can also be used to diagnose motor faults. In the same way, C02, you can check the voltage of the power supply to your sewing machine by pressing S and P keys simultaneously. Then you can see the C01 display. Change the plus button to CO2. Now press the P key. Now your display will show the voltage of the power supply provided to the sewing machine. The voltage should remain at a constant value of 230 volts. And any voltage that is too high or too low or fluctuates too frequently from 230 volts may cause damage to your servo motor. If you have made a mistake while trying to change the parameters of your sewing machine's servo motor, and you are unable to identify what went wrong and how to correct it, don't panic. Turn off the motor's power switch. Wait a few moments for the LED light and display to turn off. Press the P button to turn on the power switch. When the motor turns on, remove your finger from the P button. All settings are reset to default settings. Reset to default settings second method. In standby mode, press P and plus. Then you see P00 mode. Press and hold the S button for 3 seconds. All settings are reset to default settings. You can see that the settings that were there before the reset are restored 100% the same way. If you feel like I worked hard to make this video for you, and if you feel like this video was helpful to you, like the video, share the video, and comment with your thoughts.